Hello students, we are here with two stories about flying, part 2, black aeroplane. In our last video, we had done part 1, his first flight. Students, the previous part deals with the parental love and care. Parental love is unparalleled to any other love. We are blessed to have parents as our shelter who always give their best to train their children to live independently. They are our cosmic energy. A journey starts from parental love and ends with them. Rest all the relations have diversions and they don't care for us. Even we too. Without parental love, we are nothing. Let's not choose a day to celebrate parenthood. Instead, every breath we take is a celebration of their blessings. So students, please respect your parents. Long live our parenthood. Now let's continue with part 2. To start with part 2, part 2 is a demonstration of valor and strength and determination in the midst of turbulence in the sky. The pilot of the black aeroplane is the writer himself. Here the whole chapter is referred in the first form, that is I. I means the narrator himself. He wants to take off from Paris to reach his family in England. He wants to have delicious breakfast, so always he fantasizes that he will reach his family and is going to have his delicious breakfast with his family. It was at night the narrator takes off from Paris in his Dakota aeroplane DS-088. This is the name of his aircraft. For few hours, the sky was bright with stars and moon. After some time, he sees black cloud storm coming his way. But he was determined to fly his plane into the storm. He lost control with the traffic control, that is the air traffic control ATC on the ground. He calls for Mayday. Mayday means help. Whenever there is a problem in the air or water, the help call is known as Mayday. In the midst of the storm, he sees a black aeroplane signaling him to follow. As an obedient child, the narrator follows it, and within few minutes he was able to come out of the black storm. Now let's look paragraph wise. The first paragraph says, the moon was coming up in the east behind me and stars were shining in the clear sky above me. There wasn't a cloud in the sky. I was happy to be alone high up above the sleeping countryside. I was flying my old Dakota aeroplane over France back to England. I was dreaming of my holiday and looking towards to being with my family. I looked at my watch, 1:30 in the morning. Now he was flying to reach his family. He wanted to reach his family and have his breakfast. And he was fantasizing. He was dreaming of it. He was thinking of reaching his family and having his breakfast. He took his flight at night. The whole countryside. Countryside means village. The whole village was sleeping as it was night, and he was flying high up in the sky and he was over France. So Paris is the capital of France. I should call Paris control soon, I thought. As I looked down past the nose of the aeroplane, I saw the light of a big city in front of me. I switched on the radio and said, Paris control, Dakota DS-088 here. Can you hear me? I'm on my way to England. Over. The voice from the radio answered me immediately. DS-088, I can hear you. You ought to turn 12 degrees west now. DS-088, over. Now, whenever the pilot takes off, he has the contact with the ground. That is with the air traffic control. And they guide them to which way they are supposed to go. They have got a compass in the cockpit. Cockpit is the seat of the pilot. So through the cockpit, they get connected to the ground who is controlling the flight. So here compass guides them to pass through the directions. So here he had the contact and she guided them to turn 12 degrees west. I checked the map and the compass, switched over to my second and last fuel tank and turned the Dakota 12 degrees west towards England. I'll be in time for breakfast, I thought. A good big English breakfast. Everything was going well. It was all an easy flight. So he thought, he was all the time thinking of having his English breakfast with his family to reach England and to be on time with his family. So he turned to 12 degree west of England. So his en route was to west towards England, and he turned towards England. He saw his compasses working and his fuel was also there. Paris was about 150 kilometers behind me when I saw the clouds. Storm clouds, they were huge. They looked like black mountains standing in front of me across the sky. I knew I could not fly up and over them, and I did not have enough fuel to fly around them to the north or south. I ought to go back to Paris, I thought, but I wanted to get home. I wanted the breakfast. I'll take the risk, I thought, and flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. Now he was 150 kilometers ahead of Paris. He had left Paris far behind, and when he saw in front of him, there was a huge black cloud, very dark. It was rain cloud, storm cloud, and they were so huge, they looked like black mountains standing in front of him across the sky. And he thought he couldn't fly in between them, he couldn't fly over them. So he straight away went into the storm, taking the risk because he wanted to reach his home. Inside the cloud, everything was suddenly black. It was impossible to see anything outside the aeroplane. The old aeroplane jumped and twisted in the air. I looked at the compass. I couldn't believe my eyes. The compass was turning round and round and round. It was dead. It would not work. The other instruments were suddenly dead too. I tried the radio. Now he took the risk and he embarked inside the black cloud because he had the determination that I have to reach my family morning and have to have my breakfast with them. So without looking anything, he just took his flight inside the black cloud, and there was nothing seen inside because it was dark everywhere. He was frightened. At one moment, his flight started turning up and down. His compass lost the control. He couldn't believe his eyes. The compass was not working because it lost the connection with the air traffic control. Paris control, Paris control, can you hear me? There was no answer. The radio was dead too. I had no radio, no compass, and I could not see where I was. I was lost in the storm. Then in the black clouds quite near me, I saw another aeroplane. It had no lights on its wings, and I could see it flying next to me through the storm. I could see the pilot's face turned towards me. I was very glad to see another person. He lifted one hand and waved, "Follow me." He was saying, "Follow me. He knows that I am lost." I thought he's trying to help me. So there is a saying, right? If there is no one, there is God to help you. So there was no one in the black storm. All of a sudden, he started contacting Paris control from where he had taken off, and there was no answer from there because his compass stopped working. So all of a sudden, he saw a black aeroplane and a person there, the pilot. He's signaling him to follow him. So now he felt little bit relaxed that someone is there to help me. He turned his aeroplane slowly to the north in front of my Dakota so that it would be easier for me to follow him. I was very happy to go behind the strange aeroplane like an obedient child. After half an hour, the strange black aeroplane was still there in front of me in the clouds. How there was only enough fuel in the old Dakota's last tank to fly for 5 or 10 minutes more. Now he saw the pilot of the black aeroplane. He came in front of this pilot, this narrator's aeroplane, and he was signaling him to follow him. So that black aeroplane turned towards north. So the pilot, the narrator, he too turned towards the north, following him, and followed him, and he saw his fuel tank. There was not enough fuel left in his oil tank. It had only 5 or 10 minutes fuel where he could fly. So he was scared, what will happen? Then all of a sudden, both came out of that black cloud. I was starting to feel frightened again, but then he started to go down and I followed through the storm. Suddenly I came out of the clouds and saw two long straight lines of lights in front of me. It was a runway, an airport. I was safe. I turned to look for my friend in the black aeroplane, but the sky was empty. There was nothing there. The black aeroplane was gone. I could not see it anywhere. So this was a help in disguise for the narrator, the pilot. So here he says, I followed like an obedient child the black aeroplane pilot. We came out of the cloud and he was flying downwards. So our pilot, the pilot of Dakota 088, he followed that black aeroplane, the strange pilot who had guided him, and he came out of the black clouds and he came below and he saw two lines. The two lines were the runway where the aircraft had to land. So now he was satisfied. I landed and was not sorry to walk away from the old Dakota near the control tower. I went and asked a woman in the control center where I was and who the other pilot was. I wanted to say thank you. She looked at me very strangely and then laughed. Another aeroplane? Up there in the storm, no other aeroplanes were flying tonight. Yours was the only one I could see on the radar. So who helped me to arrive there safely without a compass or a radio and without any more fuel in my tanks? Who was the pilot on the strange black aeroplane flying in the storm without lights? So these were the questions rioting in the mind of the pilot of Dakota 088. He was thinking, who was that? And the lady is telling that there was no other aeroplane in our radar. Only yours was the one that was flying in the sky. He was wondering, then what was it? He thanked God and he wanted to thank that black aeroplane pilot. But that pilot was not there and no aeroplane was there. So the message given in this part 2 is, courage is guided by faith. When we have courage and determination, we can overcome any hurdle or problem. The spirit of I can do and I am the best can overcome any obstacle. One can reach the moon beneath the ocean or the peak. The thing is, you should have determination, strong determination. Let's take an example. We have good example in front of us. All are facing the pandemic, but believe me children, you are the little soldiers who are fighting this virus tooth and nail. Staying indoor and doing your duty sincerely. A big salute to all my little soldiers. Stay connected to us through e-learning. Enjoy each bit of it. Stay blessed. Thank you all.